Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah rabbil alamin wassalatu wassalamu ala asyrafil anbiya wal mursalin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Alhamdulillah, with the grace of Allah Subhanahu wa taala, we're able to continue our video on psychology research PIP. So I've given you the idea that we are a da'wah organization, that we give free life coach training program, alright, to all over the world, and inshallah online, and you can do it quite easily. And we have motivational coaching, mentoring and counseling module, more than 600 videos. And then now we are going embarking on psychology research PIP. You go to YouTube, psychology research PIP, there will be a new YouTube channel for you to find out about all the research that we do. Also, the same video will be uploaded into Islamic Psychology PIP YouTube. There's the current YouTube channel that you are watching. We are still increasing the number of videos from 400. Every one of this psychology research, we would upload that. And this psychology research is based on 6 areas of our interest: consciousness research, mind-body research, heart-based calm research, positive Islamic cognitive behavior therapy research, spiritual emotional mental integration research, positive Islamic psychology research. So now I'm going to give you some ideas of number 6, positive Islamic psychology research. Alright, so for this positive Islamic psychology research, we have to work on 6 levels. That means first the level of the self, then the family, society, ummah, global, and then the universe. So most important is how we as a Muslim develop ourselves so that we become a human being that is achieve fullness in life. No doubt there are trials and tribulations, there will be difficulties, there will be anguish, there will be suffering, there will be accidents. But overall, it is a life that is joyous, of a life well lived, a life of purpose and meaning, a life that you bring about the fullness of your ubudiyah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and receiving His nur and His light. Alright, so how are we going to do that? I have given you the framework. Alright. And today I'm going to dwell on our beautiful friend, Sheikh Umar Sulaiman. He is from the Yaqeen Institute for Islamic Research. You go to YouTube, Yaqeen Institute for Islamic Research, and he has a lot of series. You go to his playlist. But what I want to recommend is that the soundness of his explanation on the nature of the self, insofar as the living in a contemporary world, especially now he's from America, how they interact with other faith, how they interact with atheists, how they bring about a beautiful Islam, is something that I want you to learn from him. I cannot elucidate the beauty of Islam like Sheikh Umar Sulaiman. So you go to Sheikh Umar Sulaiman, Yaqeen Institute for Islamic Research. And then he has a lot of playlists. And one of the very interesting playlists that he has for this Ramadan is Allah Loves series. So he has key human attributes that will bring about a transformation of ourselves so that we can become a wonderful, truthful Muslim practicing Islam in a contemporary society. That means that's why if I give you an example of a sheikh from, say, Saudi Arabia, well, it may not be relevant to you because we are going to a globalized world, and the answer to the future of Islam lies not in Saudi Arabia but lies in America, in Europe, in UK, where great sheikh, for example, like in UK, Sheikh Abdul Hakam Murad. You go to Cambridge Muslim College, you have lots of videos. Or you go back to America, the same Sheikh Hamza Yusuf and his teacher Sheikh Abdullah bin Baya. These are the people who are thinking and bestowed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the highest level of hima, the highest level of intellectual capability to bring about a positive change for the individual Muslim and the Ummah. So now I'm talking about Sheikh Umar Sulaiman, Yaqeen Institute for Islamic Research, and you go to his Allah Loves series, and each and every one of his video is about 5 minutes, so it's not so heavy. And each and every one of his video is with the Quranic and Hadith supporting the view of how he relate to this, and a short story, and the integration in contemporary 21st century. That is a kind of Islam that we must bring about. Because if we talk about this 19th century Islam or the 7th century Islam, the context has changed completely. That's why within this framework, we can be true to Islam, true to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, true to the sunnah, true to the tradition of this deen, without compromising. We are not compromising. We are not becoming a liberal Muslim, but we can live in peace and harmony with all humanity. So the first key in positive Islamic psychology is how we can then transform ourselves. And the key to that transformation, frankly, is you go and learn from Sheikh Umar Sulaiman, Yakin Institute of Islamic Research, and go to 5 minutes a day with him for your personal transformation, because his series, the Allah Love series, is so beautiful. All right, for example, what are the things that Allah loves us? Number one is piety. So how we commit ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in terms of our iman, Islam and ihsan. So we must develop that. So that's the first priority. Or how we are going to, because we are all sinners in this world, we commit a lot of wrongdoings, evil within our lifetime. What we need to do? Tawbah, repentance. All right? So as a Muslim in the 21st century, how are you going to have achievement? You must have excellence. So this is 5 minutes, 5 minutes, 5 minutes. All right? And then how you're going to develop a wonderful relationship with yourself, your family, society, and the world? You must have trust. All right? And how are you going to go through the trials and tribulation in life? You must have patience. So 5 minutes of patience training for you. All right? Then how are we Muslims going to embark on a journey to bring this world to be a better world, a just world? So you have the understanding of justice. And how are you going to be a Muslim of strength? So you must have strength. You must have the capacity to carry this, the weight of our servitude as our khalifahood on this earth. How are we going to steward this earth, to steer it towards the beautiful deen and the beautiful way of life that is within the framework of this revelation by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So we must have strength. So we have independence. So each and every one of us must be independent in our striving, independent of our doing our work, so that we don't become a burden to other people and other society. We don't become beggars. We become achievers in life. So we have independence. And how are we going to have honor? Because an upright, wonderful human being must have honor, self-honor, not honor killing, not doing harmful things, but honor in the sense of defending what is right and avoiding what is wrong. And how you do it? With what? With gentleness. So in Islam, this is the deen of kindness, of caring, of love, of gentleness. So Sheikh Umar Sulaiman explained this whole idea of gentleness from the Quran and from the Sunnah. So from here we can see that each and every one of these title is one video. Each and every one of this title gives you a good learning experience in terms of positive Islamic psychology. I'm teaching you positive Islamic psychology, but I'm going back to the traditional teacher, like Sheikh Umar Sulaiman. He's not only a traditional teacher, but he is versed in many fields. So we talk about gentleness. Then, not only that, how this ummah can grow and become an ummah that is respected, we must have humility, consistency, cleanliness, and so on. So these are some of the things that you can see the Allah Love series. Alright? And from there, inshallah, you will learn and then come back to our Islamic Psychology PIP YouTube or Psychology Research PIP YouTube, this new channel, and then promote it, subscribe, tell your friends about what we are doing, providing free life coach training program. We are not training you to become psychologists, but we are training you to become life coach, learning about motivation, Islamic Islamic coaching, Islamic mentoring, and Islamic counseling at the highest level. And for those of you who are studying psychology or psychiatry or medicine or social sciences or human sciences, you're always welcome and learn more about Psychology Research PIP, and together we help to make this world a better world, knowing that we are the sincere servant of Allah, His Khalifa, His steward on this earth, always striving to make ourselves good, helping others to be good, and making the world good, inshallah.